My name is John Lennon. I'm aged 82, and I was born in Scotland on the Mullaghbyn Isle, a beautiful country.
I'm Tina Neumhalgren, I'm 74, don't feel old, but I am. I came from Holland 58 years ago. My family are only born here, my children, so they didn't think I was this, but I only found out the other day I'm still Dutch as well, because we got naturalised before I was 21, so I'm quite pleased with that actually, so I've got two nationalities.
I'm Bob, I'm 73 years old. I've just had surgery on my forehead for cancer, and I go to step into life Salisbury, which is a terrific course. And I do knitting, I do crocheting, and I go to the friendship group. And they're all women in these groups. I'm the only male, and I love it. Yeah.
Hello, my name's May Turner. I'm an elder for the Aboriginal clients and people in the community. I just like to give myself into everything and everything. So I like to keep myself busy and keep me out of trouble.
Werner's definition for resilience is surviving and thriving in the face of adversity. This also covers good developmental outcomes despite high risk status, sustained competence under stress, and recovery from trauma. What is resilience to you?
Resilience means to me to try to see the better side of things. Occasionally I do get depressed, but I can always see my way out. To be thankful for what you've got. Most of all, to have my faith, because whatever happens, I will keep that. And to be open to other people as well. So your world is a lot bigger if you are open to other people as well as your own doing, so to speak.
Well, it's being able to cope with adversity. You know, life doesn't always run smoothly and things happen. And when my wife died, it took me a year, a good year, in the house before I decided that I would have to alter things. Listening to my wife before she died, she did say to me, "I don't want you to stay at home, John. I want you to get out," and which is what I did. And one of the things that I have found out is that you have to go out to meet people, because they won't come to you. You can sit at home for the rest of your life and you'll be as lonely then as you were at the beginning. So to go out, and then I met so many people at the croquet, which I loved.
Resilience to me was my daughter, after my wife had passed away, said to me, "Don't look back, Dad, look forward." And I said, "What do you mean?" She said, come with me to step into life," which I did, and I haven't looked back since. It's been terrific, and my life is perfect right now. It is. I'm so happy, even though my wife has gone.
It's a thing that you've been brought up with, that you've had contact and guidance, and it gives me that up and go, the drive to keep doing what I think is good for people and family and relations. So, yeah. So it really means that what keeps you going.
There's been a lot of research about resilience and well-being. Professor Martin Seligman defines well-being in terms of PERMA, and his PERMA dashboard includes five elements: positive emotion, engagement, relationships, meaning, and accomplishment. He believes that each of these contribute to an authentic and sustained sense of well-being. He also went on to develop PERMA Plus and added a number of other elements, including nutrition, physical activity, sleep, resilience, optimism, and community connectedness. The first element we'll explore through these stories is positive emotion. Positive emotions are an essential part of our well-being. Happy people look back on the past with gladness, look into the future with hope, and they enjoy and cherish the present. What does positive emotion mean for you?
Most of my life I've been quite positive about it. To me at the moment there's no point in looking back, because I can't alter that. but I can in the future. And I look forward to this year, hopefully in August, I shall go on my way to Scotland for a holiday. You know, so that's something that, and I think you need to have something to get up in the morning to look forward to. To me, this time of my life has been a beautiful time. And I said, don't be afraid of growing old, because I said it can be the most beautiful time.
Right now, being in Salisbury, involved in this ambassador community, which I really enjoy, and I get good feedback from that. Having the other people in more or less the same boat as I am, and they've all got their problems, but they're also very positive, and I really like that. And everybody needs something to feed on, and to me that's my food. I do need that kind of input from other people.
I'm always positive, yes. I don't know where it comes from. Even when my wife was sick, I was positive. I was going to stay with her. I was going to look after her. And it worked out that way until she went into nursing home. After she passed, it was like the weight of the world had been lifted from my shoulders. She was at peace. And I could move forward. What a terrific day that was. I blessed that day because she was so ill. And now, life is a dream.
I think I'm a very positive person, not only in my life, my well-being, everything where I look, where I see things, it's there for me if I want it. And I never try to not do it. I always have to try, like everything in my life, I get to try. Like from jumping off a roof to, you know, just going for outside for a walk. So, yeah. I don't have much negative thoughts or anything like that in my life. It's just always been positive thinking. So, and I think it's what makes you a better person, to be like that and to keep going and to keep doing it. So that's my goals, and that's my ambition, is to keep it up and not deteriorate over it, you know. So I love life. So.
Engagement. When we focus on doing the things we truly enjoy and care about, we can begin to engage completely with the present moment and enter the state of being known as flow. Can you tell us something that you'd love to just totally engage with? Something that gives you the sense of flow?
Well, croquet. It's, when I'm 90, I hope to still be playing. You know, and I've tried to get people a little bit younger than me, pensioners, to join a croquet club, because I would still go down there, even if I couldn't play. I would go down to sit and have a coffee with them and talk and watch, you know. It really was a means for me to get back into society again. I've met so many people and so many friends in that it's really been brilliant, you know. I've got a lot to thank croquet for. I go to bed at night and I have my Walkman and my earphones, and I put a disc on and I sit and I listen to Sir Richard Burton reading poetry. Now, you can never feel uptight lying there listening to that.
You know when you get something in your head and you want to do it and to be the best of it, and knowing that you can do it, that was I liked, knowing that I can still walk 5 kilometres a day in the morning when you got the rest of the day to do what you have to do. But to have it done before you start, it's so rewarding. It makes you feel good and stirs you up, you know, more.
Last week I was sitting outside PW and a couple of older people, different occasions, were talking. And they just started talking about their troubles, and I didn't say anything, or just interrupted a little. And they both said, well, thank you for listening, and I think it's very much needed. People need to engage more with other people and listen to them. Don't have to solve their problems, but you listen to them. So that means being engaged to me.
stored in the mind. You've got to live the moment. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here yet. All you've got is now. I do a lot of knitting at home. I'm watching TV or crocheting, one of the two. And if I'm not doing that, I'm out walking. The knitting started when domiciliary care came and said, you need to have a break. I said, I'm not sick. My wife's sick. I said, yes, but what happens if you get sick? So I started taking 2 hours and I didn't know what to do myself. She said, there's a Jack Young Centre, and that opened my eyes. I went to the Jack Young Centre, I started a knitting group, and walked in with 25 women, sat there. My God, what have I let myself in for? But no, I wouldn't change a thing now. Yeah, I get a lot of attention, good and bad.
Relationships. Everyone needs someone. We enhance our well-being and share it with others by building strong relationships with the people around us, family, friends, co-workers, and neighbours. Can you tell us about important relationships in your life?
I come from a large family of 15. I'm number 7 in the family. 11 boys and 2 girls. My mum lived till she was 93, my dad 86 years of age. But there's only 6 of us left now out of the 15. Yeah, we've lived on Yorkshire Peninsula and Port Pierce over there, mission station over there. So I had a lot of family. Family were very important to us on the mission.
My family, we're such a close family. I'm so lucky. Having a strong family, I think, is the big issue. On the hot days like Saturday, all 3 of my children will ring up and say, are you drinking enough water? Have you got the air conditioner on? Are you looking after yourself? Yes, yes, yes. They'll say, come up for tea. So I'll go up for tea. And that happens quite regularly. The family will get together on birthdays, Christmas, Easter. We all get together. And it's a good time. That's positive. That's I love that.
To have a strong relationship is very important. And although I don't have that as much with my own near family, I've got very good friends whom I can relate to, Aussies as well as Dutchies. It's very important at our age that we have people our own age as well, because they come from the same background.
I was lucky in the family I was born in, and then I was doubly lucky in the person I married. So I've always, throughout my life, I've had love around me, and that now means a lot to me because I've made some beautiful friends. People might laugh like, but the biggest friends I have are aged between 38 and 50. And I love being with them, and they seem to enjoy my company. And by meeting them, having lunch with them, and chatting to them, it stops me from feeling old.
Meaning. We are at our best when we dedicate time to something greater than ourselves. This might be religious faith, community work, family, politics, a charity, a professional or creative goal. Can you describe where you get your sense of meaning from?
Sense of meaning for me is to belong to the community, to belong to my family a bit more than I am, but I'm fixing that, I think. Of course, me too. And to know that you're valued as a person, not only in a small community, but in a wider community, to me that is important. I mean, for many years you say, what can I do? But that's the wrong attitude. The attitude is, I can put my little bit in, and altogether we achieve what we set out to do. So I think your life is like that. Don't take no for an answer. Try to find a way around it.
I try to help others that are trained, that have just come out to train. I try to help others that join the Jack Young Centre. I put in to become a volunteer. Michael wants me to do another speech. I'm looking forward to that one too. I reckon that'll be good fun.
You know, I'm never always in a state of sadness. It's just now and again. But when I get into a state like that, I look out an LP and put some music on, and I mean, I can sit there, I can have a cry, but Music helps me a lot. It really does. In fact, I said in my story that music is where I find my God. And that is true, because no human could write the beautiful music that we listen to. I put on Mozart's clarinet concerto and I lie back on the settee and I've gone. You know, it just takes me away.
Well, I go to church every Sunday. I get involved with the community a lot. That's my inspiration as well, is to get involved with the people in the community, the people that have an hardship, if I can help them in any way, be at meetings so that I can make it better for them. Just to show the people that it's not just for me, it's for them as well. And I just like knocking myself out and doing what I can do for other people. So, and I think God gives me strength as well and keeps me safe and gives me the energy and gives me the spirit to keep going.
Accomplishment. Everyone needs to win sometimes. To achieve well-being and happiness, we must be able to look back on our lives with a sense of accomplishment and reflect. I did it and I did it well. Can you tell us about an accomplishment that you're proud of or that gives you a strong sense of well-being?
My accomplishment is I've lost 18 kilo in 3 years and I'm running. I started with a trainer, this trainer, and only train once a week with him, with weights. He said, you know what, that's not going to be enough. I said, well, I can't afford it. Well, it's $20 a week. He said, well, when we come out to training, why don't you go for a walk? I started walking. Stand off 2 kilometres, went up to 3, went up to 4, got up to 5 now. And I was going out in the morning, and I thought, I can do that again tonight. So I'm doing 10k a day now. I've got that much energy, you know, I can't get out and train enough. No, I love going out and walking. So I started dropping weight, and everybody knows. Everybody tells me, you look so good, Bob. You don't look 73. I don't feel any different to anybody else, but I'm lucky. I've got use of my limbs, my arms, and I can do that. A lot of people my age can.
Proudest thing that I am proud of, really, is my 4 sons. To grow up in the UK in the 60s wasn't easy, and to see how they've matured, you know, I look at them now, very proud.
First of all, I put 7 children into this world and they're all working. They're all quite successful in their own way. They're responsible adults, which I'm quite pleased with in this day and age. And also, my involvement with the Dutch community. I set up this age home, which I'm very proud of. And walking into that, which I don't often do, but to see the happy faces of people there, I think I'm quite proud of the fact I started all this. So, despite the fact that people said you can't do this, it's too hard, you can't tell the Dutchie that it's too hard. No, there's always a way around.
My last child I had, I was very sick with him. They didn't know whether I was going to live or die. And I thought, I've got to make myself strong. So, I started taking up golf. My husband got me to golf and I beat him and I beat everyone else that was teaching me how to play and I loved it. Representing South Australia in the golf tournament has really lifted my spirits and to keep me going and, you know, to keep fighting. I've won a lot of trophies and a lot of golf competitions.
So we've just explored the 5 different elements of PERMA.
My life is perfect right now. I'm so happy.
I'm more than grateful for what I've got now.
To me, this time of my life has been a beautiful time.
I love life.